Congratulations on the purchase of your new Chrysler LHS or 300M. It means a lot to us that you've selected a vehicle manufactured by Daimler Chrysler. And we want to make sure that you understand how some of the most important features work. Some of these features may or may not be included with the particular vehicle you've purchased, but most of the procedures will help you gain a better understanding of your car and provide you with helpful operating tips. Call your dealer if you're unsure of the options that came with your vehicle. So, we urge you to watch the entire video. For your convenience, this video has been divided into four color-coded segments that can be located easily while fast-forwarding. The safety and security segment is preceded by a red screen. Popular features, blue. The maintenance segment, yellow. And additional features, green. The child restraint system operating instructions, for example, are found in the safety and security segment. Simply fast forward until you see the red screen, and the child restraint system subject will follow shortly. For reference, a convenient guide to most of the video's content is listed on the back cover of the tape box. Now, sit back and enjoy the program. We'll begin with a few of your car's many safety and security features. Safety belts are one of your car's most important safety features. For your comfort, both front outboard belts are adjustable, with five different positions to accommodate people of different heights. To raise or lower your shoulder belt, use this button. It's a one-handed operation, and as you can see, very easy to accomplish. For added comfort, when you move your seat back and forth, the traveling lap belt buckle moves with you. A light will appear on the instrument panel, and a chime will sound to remind you to fasten your safety belt. The chime will stop after a few seconds, but the light will remain on until you fasten your safety belt. Your car is also equipped with the next generation of airbags, which are environmentally friendly and certified to the federal regulations that allow less forceful airbags. There are a few simple steps you can take to help improve the effectiveness of a supplemental deploying airbag. All occupants should wear their lap and shoulder belts properly. Never place the shoulder belt behind, on, or under the arm. Driver and front passenger seats should be moved back as far as practical from the supplemental airbags. All children 12 years old and under should always ride buckled up in the back seat, with the shoulder belt properly positioned. Children weighing up to 60 pounds should be secured in a back seat, in a rear or forward-facing child seat, or forward-facing booster seat. Older children not using a child seat should ride properly adjusted and buckled up in a back seat. There are three types of child restraint systems generally available. Rearward-facing infant seats for babies up to a year old and weighing less than 20 pounds. Forward-facing child seats for children older than 1 year and weighing from 20 to 40 pounds. And forward-facing booster seats for children from 30 to 60 pounds. If you're using a booster seat, be sure to adjust the seat side to side as well as the turning loop so that the shoulder belt is properly located and goes over the child's shoulder and not the child's neck. In addition, user-ready child seat top tether anchors have been provided behind the rear seats. You can more firmly secure the child seat into position by attaching it to the anchor using a tether strap that's included with your child seat or purchased separately. Infants less than 1 year old should be carried in a rearward-facing add-on child seat and used only in a back seat. Never install rearward-facing child seats in any front passenger seating position. The deploying airbag could strike the seat and cause severe or fatal injury to the infant. Refer to your owner's manual, the driver and passenger sun visors, and the instructions provided with your child seat or booster seat to make sure you're using it correctly. For added safety, you must apply the car's brakes before you can shift the transmission out of park. If you do not apply the brakes first, you will not be able to shift out of park.
Your car has a standard anti-lock braking system, or ABS, which is designed to provide greater control in unfavorable braking conditions. The primary benefit of ABS is that it prevents the wheels from locking up, which helps the driver maintain steering control and directional stability in hard braking situations or when braking on slippery surfaces. ABS works differently than conventional brakes by automatically pumping the brakes for you during these adverse braking conditions. An ABS computer constantly monitors speed sensors located at each wheel. During braking, if one wheel is slowing more quickly, the ABS computer will send a signal to special valves for each brake to avoid locking up that wheel. Press firmly on the brake pedal and let ABS do the pumping. You should never pump the pedal yourself because manual pumping makes ABS less effective and reduces the controllability of your vehicle. Once ABS has been activated, you may feel the brake pedal pulsate and hear some system noise, which is caused by the brakes being applied and released many times each second. Just press the brake pedal down firmly and let the much faster ABS computer do the work. This avoids wheel lockup and enables you to maintain steering control. The performance of ABS and remembering to keep constant pressure on the brake pedal may take a little getting used to. But just remember that ABS works best when you let it do its job. And as always, avoid driving too fast for conditions. You'll see the yellow ABS light briefly when you start the car. When you first accelerate, you may also hear some slight system noise and feel a pulsation in the brake pedal. The system is performing a self-check to ensure that its components are working properly. If at any time the ABS light remains continuously lit, the system is warning you that it's not functioning properly and that you need to take your vehicle in for service. In the meantime, you'll still be able to brake as if you had a non-ABS system.
The low-speed traction control system is designed to reduce wheel slip by automatically engaging the brakes momentarily on the front driving wheels whenever they lose traction. Traction control uses components of your car's ABS to optimize available traction at speeds below 35 miles per hour. It's particularly helpful when accelerating on slippery surfaces. When traction control is activated, it's normal to hear some associated system noises. The traction control system always remains in the standby mode, ready to be activated whenever needed, unless it has been intentionally switched off. When the traction control system is active, the green track control light illuminates. If you ever need to rock the vehicle out of mud, snow, or ice, you can turn the system off by pressing the track control switch until track off appears. To turn the system back on, you'll need to press the track control switch again and hold it until the lamp goes off. You should be aware that the traction control system will deactivate to prevent overheating the brake system after heavy use. This is a normal condition. If this happens, the track-off light will appear and remain lit for approximately 4 minutes until the brake system cools.
Your car's standard rear door child protection lock system helps provide a safer backseat environment for small children. This safety feature prevents rear seat occupants from opening the rear doors from the inside. When safety locks are engaged, the rear doors will only open using their respective outside door handles, provided the conventional lock is in the unlocked position. To engage the safety locks on each door, simply open either rear door and move this lever up. You may find it helpful to use a key to move the lever. To disengage the lock and to permit the doors to be open from the inside, simply move the lever down. Always check the locking and unlocking directions shown on the label, as they may be different from previous years and from the directions we have just shown here.
Two additional standard features are the remote keyless and illuminated entry systems. The keyless entry system uses a handy transmitter to lock or unlock doors, open the trunk, and activate the illuminated entry system from up to 40 feet away. It also has a panic alarm feature. To unlock the driver's door only, press the unlock button once. Notice that all the interior courtesy lamps also turn on. To unlock all four doors, press the unlock button twice within 5 seconds. Be sure that you make distinct presses. To lock all four doors, press the lock button one time. All doors will lock, the horn will chirp once, and the park and turn signal lamps will flash to acknowledge the signal. The interior lamps will immediately fade off. To open the trunk, press the trunk release button twice within a 2-second period. See your owner's manual if you want to reprogram the trunk to open with a single press. When you press and hold the panic button, your keyless entry system becomes a